If there is such thing as the end of a data pipeline, it's typically a report of some sort or something that's getting in the hands of our stakeholders. But if you've ever built one of these reports, you know that it's never just a simple handoff. There's always some sort of back and forth or request for more features, more functionality. But what I want to talk about in this video is where you decide to make those changes and how you decide to manage it. And the two schools of thought here are, number one, making changes directly into a report, or do you make these changes in code, in the database, in the transformation layer behind the scenes? So in this video, I want to make a case for that. I want to share three reasons why I personally think you're better off keeping your logic in the database itself rather than trying to store it within your reporting tool. And hopefully it'll help you think through what's best for your team and ultimately the precedent you want to set going forward. So the first reason why I think you're better off keeping your data logic in the database itself and not in the report layer or the reporting tool is for better visibility. By the time something gets to a report, it's already gone through, most likely, a lot of transformation layers. And a lot of times the code that you've built there is stored in its own place. Hopefully you're using a tool that has version control, like let's say DBT, or maybe it's Data Factory, or maybe it's something else that has a backup shared repository of your code. So as you're making changes to that data transformation pipeline, you can track line by line the changes that were made, when it was changed, who made it, and the history of all of that in place. But once you get to the reporting layer, once you create a report, that is typically stored separately, if at all. And I know there are some reporting tools and visualization tools that are also code-based, but what I'm talking about here is the common data visualization tool. We're talking Tableau, Power BI, Looker, these types of things that, yes, they might have some version control aspects to it, but it's typically separate. It's not congruent with the rest of the project. So what happens is a lot of times more logic is completely isolated from the rest of the project, and it's unique to, let's say, a particular report. So again, from a visibility perspective, you've kind of lost that, or you have to look in different places, which just makes the whole thing pretty inefficient. In addition, there's typically not as good of a workflow when it comes to making those changes. Whereas if you have a data transformation project and a process in place, you'll have a whole consistent workflow of how you write syntax, building it first in a development environment and then pushing it through to production, and hopefully having some documentation along the way. If you're just working within a reporting tool, there are potentially ways you can do that. It's again, just not as easy and fluid to do that. And again, you're separating these two workflows. And another point on visibility here, which I think is really important, is that once you start working with logic in a reporting layer, there's so many different places where it can live. For example, you might be creating your own custom model, let's say within the reporting tool that you use for one or multiple reports, and or you have column level logic that's adding even more transformation on top of it. And while these are great functionalities to have within a tool and there's a lot you can do with it, if your goal is to establish a reliable and consistent data architecture, this is gonna just open you up for confusion and conflicts because you don't have the right visibility on where things are happening. So just think of the common scenario where somebody asks a question on a report, hey, what does this column mean? How do you answer that simple question? It's never usually that simple, but where do you look? If you have things stored in various parts of a reporting tool that's not really consistent, you're gonna have to go through multiple custom columns. It can get kind of crazy to just figure out what something means, and it still might be very challenging to figure out. Whereas if you have it in the database, hopefully it'll follow a consistent pattern and you can identify exactly where something lives, and some tools might even have a lineage tool built in to track a specific column. And you may not be able to completely eliminate the difficulty of tracking down logic just because it's in a database and just because it's in a version control tool, but again, it'll at least hopefully be easier to track down. You have more visibility into everything and all the changes rather than, again, looking in multiple places. And a lot of this leads into point number two, which is consistency. And I think you have better and more consistency when you keep everything in the database, the query codes behind the scenes, rather than handling it in the front end data viz tool. And a big reason for this is something that I've already mentioned, which is the workflow. So if you think through two different scenarios, if you want to make a change, let's say you want to add a new column or you want to change the logic of something, if you're just going straight to the data visualization tool, you can get it done and you can get it done quickly, which is great. But at the same time, there isn't a great way to test that other than maybe creating a separate report. But again, it's outside where the other code lives. Whereas if you keep it in the database, you'll have line by line version control. You'll have the ability to deploy and run tests in a database that can objectively be tested before it reaches production and your production code. You can have built-in automation to run these things. And you can also then have other people on your team review it and give feedback in a very consistent way. And this whole process collectively makes sure that your data quality is better. It makes sure that you're writing things in a consistent way so that in the future, if somebody else needs to look at your code and make a change, it follows a consistent pattern. And just overall on this point, I think it's harder to maintain consistency in what your queries look like in a data visualization tool compared to within a data transformation and a query writing tool. They're there for different purposes. They work together, but they shouldn't be a replacement for the other, in my opinion. So this is a big reason why I typically recommend you do a lot of this in the database. Now, the third point here has to do with control, and this has to do more with the people side of things, more so than, let's say, the technical reasoning behind stuff. And I bring this up because when you set the precedent to your team, to your organization, that code changes and logic changes can be made within a data visualization tool, and it doesn't have to go through the data team or the data transformation pipeline, you're going to set yourself up for a challenge to set any sort of consistent process in place. And what this will ultimately end up looking like is you're going to have a lot of rogue developers or siloed analysts that are out there making their own changes to things and adding their own logic because it's quick, it's easy. Again, not that they're trying to be malicious here, but it's just a quick workaround. Because one of the biggest secondary problems of having all sorts of people making changes and adding whatever they want is having conflicting results and not being able to say for sure what something means and then compare it to another report, because now these are showing the same name for something, but the values are different. So which one is correct? What is the single source of truth? And a lot of times this is one of the biggest things that a company and a data team wants to do, is establish consistent metrics. That's such a simple idea, but it's so hard. And a lot of times this becomes a challenge at some point because we've opened up the floodgates for anybody to really make these changes, and it gets disconnected from the rest of the data team and what's going on with the central logic of what should be used for most reports. And look, I realize that sometimes that's not what people want to hear, but you have to also be confident that in the long run, this is better off, not just for you, but for the stakeholders and for the business, because you'll be able to be more consistent and more under control with what you're presented and make sure people understand why you're doing that and why that's so important. Ultimately, most reporting tools are full of amazing features that should absolutely be used for your data team and to create great analytics products. But as a data team leader, particularly on smaller teams, it's really important that you manage and maintain where your logic lives and open yourself up to the secondary problems as a result of being a little complacent with it. So hopefully you found this helpful and can start to think about how you want to handle this on your own team. Thanks as always for watching, and I'll see you at the next video.